Hi friends, I welcome you all to EduTap. So here is another lecture under your general awareness series. So today we are going to cover the last 3 days of the month of November, and we'll be covering general awareness news from last 3 days, and also there will be MCQs at the end of this lecture so that you can solve those MCQs and get to know that what information is actually important from the news. So this video is going to be helpful for RBI Grade B, NABARD Grade A, SEBI Grade A and the assistant examinations of RBI and NABARD both. So, telling you about the various courses which are being offered by us, you can just have a look on the screen. We are offering SEBI, RBI, NABARD and the combo courses of them as well. You can choose from these courses as per your requirement. And telling you about our previous results, you can see that in RBI Grade B 2017, 27 of our students could make it to the final list. And in NABARD Grade A 2018, there were 46 seats, and out of those seats, 26 were taken by the EduTapians. And similarly, for the RBI Grade B 2018, we are expecting a great result in the final list, and 280 selections have been made in the phase 2. So many students of EduTap are going through the interview phase. So now starting on with your lecture today, so let us just see what is your first news. So your very first news is about the launching of the platform to monitor the public health surveillance. So Health Ministry has launched this platform, and this platform is called as the Integrated Digital Surveillance Program. Now this IDSP is actually a segment of the IHIP. IHIP stands for Integrated Health Information Platform. So as you can see from the name itself, Integrated Health Information Platform means that the platform on which all the data related to the health would be available on the particular platform. Now this particular initiative, that is IDSP, has been launched in 7 states as of now. The 7 states, you can just read the name of these states here: Andhra Pradesh, then Telangana, Himachal Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala, Odisha and Uttar Pradesh. So basically this initiative is going to provide the kind of real-time data to the policy makers so that they can detect the outbreaks, and then finally they can come up with the policies which are effective in the reduction of the mortality and the morbidity. So this is a first of its kind of initiative and is expected to be to bring out a lot of change in the health sector in India particularly. So let us see about this IHIP, of which IDSP is actually a part. So it is a kind of real-time electronic health information system, and all the digital technologies would be used in this. So creation of this health record, which would be interoperable, would be there, and block level, district level and state level platforms are there, and then the integration of all the data can be made up. So just go through it, what is it related to and which ministry has rolled it, and yes, as of now the states are also important, and if the states lately changes, then that maybe this is expanded, as only the 7 states are covered under this, so we'll be covering that also, but as of now you need to keep all these things in mind. Okay, so now we will be moving to your next news. Okay, so this is about the International Geeta Festival. So it is the annual Geeta Festival, which is going to be held in the month of December in the district Kurukshetra of Haryana. So it will be organized in Kurukshetra, and the important thing is that the partner country for this year is Mauritius, and usually all the international festivals which are organized have a partner country as well as a partner state, or you can say that a theme country is also there. So this year Mauritius is the partner country for this International Geeta Festival, and Gujarat will be the partner state. So this Geeta Festival is basically commemorated so as to give the importance to the birth of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. So this year artists from many countries are going to come to this annual festival, and you also need to keep in mind that in the month of February in 2019, the same Geeta Festival is going to be organized in Mauritius as well. So keep in mind that Mauritius is the partner country this time, and the same festival is going to be organized next year in the same country. So here I have mentioned that which is the organizing body. So since it is organized in the state of Haryana, so Kurukshetra Development Board, Haryana Tourism and the district administration of the particular district are going to be involved in this particular festival. So yes, all important things about this particular news you need to keep in mind, and that would be it for you. Okay, So your next news is Raksha Mantri launches Mission Raksha Gyan Shakti. So since this is very important because first of this kind of any mission has been launched by Defense Ministry, so this becomes important for us. Now Mission Raksha Gyan Shakti, let me just tell you, is related to the IPRs. How is this? I will just explain you here that as you know, India is dependent on the technology related to defense, especially on the different countries. Now with the initiatives like Make in India and all, now there is the next step in which the boost to the IPR culture would be given. That means that we should not be dependent on the technology for the other countries, rather we should develop such technologies which are useful for the defense sector in our country itself. So this mission is going to be helpful there, and hence its name, Mission Raksha Gyan Shakti. So Raksha and Gyan have come together. So mission aims to boost the IPR culture in the indigenous defense industry in which India is actually lacking. The DGQA, that is the Director General of the Quality Assurance, has been entrusted with the responsibility. So this particular body, DGQA, is related to the quality assurance to the supplies of the defense sectors, and that is why it has been made this particular implementing agency. So I have also mentioned it here, you can just go through it, that the design or IP accounts actually cost India over 50%. That means even if we have the equipment we have brought in, if there is any changes in the technology, we have to refer to that particular country or the original manufacturer for that particular default. So this, if India boosts its IPR culture, it will be of great help. And DRDO is the body which is also going to be pushed under this Mission Raksha Gyan Shakti. So are you all clear about this mission? And all important things about this are there in this particular slide. Just go through it and then we'll move on to your next news. Okay, so another important appointment is here. So Shri Arvind Saxena has been appointed as the chairman of UPSC. So he was working as the acting chairman since June this year. Now he has been appointed as the full-fledged chairman of the Union Public Service Commission. And you can see the picture here of Shri Arvind Saxena. And let me just tell you that the chairman and members of the commission of that is UPSC, they hold the office for a term of 6 years or until they attain the age of 65 years. So this is just an added information, you can just keep it in mind. And Arvind Saxena, you need to know, this is a very important post, the constitutional body. UPSC has got its chairman now. So moving on to the next news. Okay, now this is important. It is related to the GST. See, Casio India, the Casio, as you know, is a Japanese company. It has presented the world's first GST calculator. So it has announced the launch of this GST calculator. All the there are basically two types of model which are here, and the models name are MJ120 GST and MJ12 GST. So they are particularly dedicated to the Indian market. A lot of survey was various surveys were done by the Casio so as to fix the nuances which were related to the GST, because when it was rolled out there was a lot of problem with the people to cope with the mechanism of GST, and they wanted to learn how they can calculate GST. So this calculator is there for the help. And all the 5 slabs currently which are under the GST, 0%, 5%, 12%, 18% and 28% are there in these calculators. So separate buttons are there and you need to give the command along with this and your calculated GST output would be there. So this is important, and it is interesting also to note down that such an important thing has come up. So yes, just keep in mind that Casio has come up with such a calculator, and the names are also important, because sometimes they can be asked that what are actually these things, MJ120 or MJ12 GST. And if you don't know about this news, you may get confused that are there actually such calculators which are calculating GST. So yes, that would be it. Okay, another general awareness section news is Azim Premji has been conferred with the highest French civilian honor. So here is the picture of the Wipro owner Azim Premji. He is called as the philanthropist of philanthropist businessman also, because he is involved into so many philanthropist activities, and he is the chairman of the Bangalore based IT major, that is Wipro. So he has been given this award by the French ambassador, and it is considered as the Knight of the Legion of Honor. So keep this in mind, this French civilian honor has been conferred on to Azim Premji. And why is he given so? You can just go through the slide here that he has done a lot of contribution for development of IT in India particularly, and also his company Wipro is working from past 15 years in France, and most of the employees there are from the locals only, that is, they are from France only. So that is why French government has come up with this honor. And yes, he also runs the Azim Premji Foundation for all the philanthropist activities, as well as the Azim Premji University, which is a very renowned university in India. So all these actions have been recognized by France, and he has been honored with this award. So let us move on to your next news. Now this is also important. The naval exercise between India and UK has just begun, and it is going to be conducted till December 6th. So this exercise is taking place in Goa, and Konkan 18, that means that implies Konkan 2018. So important thing is that India and United Kingdom conduct this exercise, because it is asked in exam about various naval exercises or the even military exercises whatever are conducted between the different countries. So the Konkan is actually important because it commenced in 2004 and it has been taking place, and rather it is growing on scale. It is 2018 and now also this exercise is going to take place. Important thing is that this year the focus is on the anti-air warfare, anti-surface warfare, all the anti-submarine warfare. So all these things are important here, that it is actually being broad now. The exercises are being broad under the Konkan 18. So yes, Konkan, that would be it. Moving to your next news. So there's this emergency number called as the all round emergency number, which has been rolled by the state of Himachal Pradesh. So Himachal Pradesh government has become the first state in India to launch a pan India single emergency number. So single emergency number means it will be integrated with the police, fire, health, women helpline. All these would be under the single umbrella number called which is 112. So this is important since it has been rolled by Himachal Pradesh, and this step is lauded by the Ministry of Home Affairs, because there is a plan to launch such an emergency number on across the India by the central government itself. So soon you'll be getting the news that maybe central government has also launched such kind of emergency number, but for now Himachal Pradesh is the state which has launched this number. So under this project, an emergency response center has been established in the capital of Himachal Pradesh, that is Shimla, and all the services would be integrated here. Not only this, government is also planning to come up with a mobile app called as 112 India mobile app, so that this app has the features and you don't need to call up on the particular given number. So yes, that would be it from this news. Okay, so your next important news is about the launch of HYSIS satellite. So another achievement by ISRO. So PSLV C-43 has injected the first ever satellite, that is hyperspectral imaging satellite. Now this is the first ever innovative satellite which is going to observe the applications, which is going to observe, give the observations which are going to be utilized in agriculture, forestry, geological environments, etc. So all these would be covered in this hyperspectral imaging satellite called as HYSIS. So you must know what this HYSIS is, and it has been placed in the Sun synchronous polar orbit. So Let me just tell you what this polar orbiter is. So polar orbiter is which the orbit which is actually the satellite is moving from the pole to poles. That means it will be traversing from North Pole to the South Pole. And sun synchronous means the orbit makes the satellite to have the sun energy, the solar energy all the time. So this PSLV C-43 is the classic polar satellite launching vehicle of India, and this was the 45th launch of this particular vehicle. Now, not only this HYSIS, in this particular flight, 30 foreign satellites have also been launched. So let us see about these foreign satellites also. So there were 30 satellites under the Commercial Act, and the commercial arm of ISRO, that is Antariksh Corporation Limited, had this agreement with different nations to come up with the 29 nano satellites and one micro satellite. So you don't need to learn the countries from which this satellite has come up, although I've given it here. You can just go through it, that Australia had one satellite, Canada one, Colombia, Finland, Spain, Netherlands, and USA had 23 satellites in this particular mission. So this is all important thing about this particular news. HYSIS in itself important, which is going to provide the information related to the waters, agriculture, forestry, everything. And apart from that, other 30 satellites are also there, which are the foreign based. So yes, all important things we have covered in this particular news. So your last news from this section is about the South Asian Youth Peace Conference. So this Youth Peace Conference has just taken place in New Delhi. The 3-day event was actually organized by UNESCO's arm, that is Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Education for Peace and Sustainable Development, and the Gandhi Smriti Darshan Samiti. These are the two samitis, along with STEP, that is Standing Together to Enable Peace. So this is another NGO. So all these three organizations had come together and organize this regional youth peace conference in South Asia. Now let me just tell you, since we are heading to the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, and we have covered it so many times in the previous videos that so many missions are related to this particular year commemorating the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, who is actually called as the father of the nation. So this is important related to peace conference, because Gandhi's ideals were actually related to peace only. So the countries which had come up, you need to note these countries down. So Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Maldives, Nepal and Sri Lanka. So these representatives from these countries had come up to take part in this particular conference. And yes, that would be it. All important things are here. And now we are done with your news. We'll move on to your MCQ section. Try and solve the MCQs, because all the news we have covered and the MCQs are derived from these news only. Okay. So starting with your MCQs, do let us know about your score. How do you like the video? So starting on with question number one. So Integrated Disease Surveillance Program has been launched in which of the following states recently? So we had covered that 7 states are covered under this IDSP. So identify which of these is actually out of those states. Is it Andhra Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh, or all of the above? Just pause the video, give yourself 10 seconds and try to identify the correct answer. And our correct answer is all of the above. So all these states are actually under the states which are covered under IDSP recently. Moving to question 2. This is also important. Which of the following is the partner country for the International Geeta Festival 2018 to be held in Kurukshetra, Haryana? So partner country is important, and which of the following is actually the country? Afghanistan, Malaysia, Fiji, Mauritius or Bangladesh? So you have to give the answer to this. Mention it below in the comment section. Do mark your score also so that you can let us know about your scores. and the partner country for the Geeta Festival 2018 is Mauritius. We had seen that Geeta Festival is also going to be organized in 2019 in Mauritius only. Question 3, this is also important. Mission Raksha Gyan Shakti is related to which of the following? So Raksha Gyan Shakti, is it related to Make in India, Naval Exercises, IPRs, Indigenous Satellites, or none of the above? So Mission Raksha Gyan Shakti is related to intellectual property rights, that is IPRs. So we had covered that this is an important mission in which the IPRs in indigenously developed technologies are going to be boosted. Moving on to question number 4. Which of the following personalities has been conferred with the highest French civilian honor recently? This is also important. So this is easy also. You must remember it. Is it Narendra Modi, Arun Jaitley, Ratan Tata, Azim Premji, or Sachin Tendulkar? And highest French civilian honor has been conferred to Azim Premji. So the owner of IT firm Wipro, Azim Premji, has been given this honor by the French government. Question number 5 is again an easy question. Which of the following has become the first state to launch an All India Emergency Number 112? Okay, so India is missing. I'm sorry about that. Keep just think that India is to be here. So the state which has launched this number is it Maharashtra, Himachal Pradesh, Gujarat, Telangana, or Haryana? And our correct answer is Himachal Pradesh. So Himachal Pradesh has come up, the first state to come up with such a number, such an all emergency number. And our final question of the lecture is about Konkan exercise. So Konkan is an annual naval exercise between India and Dash. So this is a typical examination question and easy one also, since we have covered it. Is it UK, US, Japan, South Korea, or France? So Konkan is an annual naval exercise between India and UK. So there is this Malabar naval exercise including India, US, and Japan. And the naval exercise between India and France is called as Varuna. So yes, Konkan is about India and UK. So these are your correct answers. Just tally your score. Do let us know what is your score and how do you like this video. So yes, that would be it, guys. In case you guys have any query, you can just drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. You can even give us a call or WhatsApp us at 8146207241. The number is there right in front of you. And you can also visit our website www.edutab.co.in. So yes, that would be it from today's lecture, guys. If you like the video and if you like the content, please do like, subscribe, and share this video. And yes, that would be it. I wish you all a very happy learning from the team EduTab, and thank you for being here.